We'll also have unique perspectives on the nation and the world from contributing analyst George Will, Washington Post executive editor Ben Bradley, Wall Street Journal correspondent Karen Elliott House, and commentator Hodding Carter.
There you see the first roundtable on the first broadcast of this week, 40 years ago, November 15th, 1981. We're proud to carry on the mission launched by David Brinkley that Sunday morning. Here's a look back at four decades of this week.
From ABC News in Washington, this week with David Brinkley.
Good morning. We're glad to have you with us. We have a new Sunday program for you, which we hope you will find useful.
The show itself is supposed to be a forum, and what this week has always been is a forum for civil debate based on facts, to hold public figures accountable, hold politicians and administration officials, members of Congress accountable for the decisions they're making every day in our name. Right. You were against the individual mandate during the campaign. Under this mandate, the government is forcing people to spend money, fining you if you don't. How is that not a tax?
Well, hold on a second, George. You do have some explaining to do if the polls mean anything.
I sure do.
Isn't it possible that you could have affected the policy if you all had spoken up sooner instead of just going along?
Let me be very specific. The answer is yes, we could have.
We all get a chance to ask the tough questions of candidates, to ask the tough questions of policymakers in our country. The President of the United States is accusing the former president of wiretapping him.
I think that this is, again, something that if this happened, Martha,
We put the key questions, the central questions, to the candidates themselves and to the people behind the candidates.
Could you be taken seriously as a presidential candidate?
Well, I think that I've built a great, great company.
Let me just ask you more about the draft business, because people are talking about that.
Mm. On the tax pledge.
Yeah.
Would you take it again?
Those of us who live and work in Washington are always being accused of being too inside the Beltway. But on this program, we've always tried to set our sights beyond the Potomac.
We've anchored this program from countless locations around the world.
I'm Martha Raddatz in Baghdad,
live here in Cairo.
I'm just back from that interview with President Putin at the site of the Sochi Olympics.
We're here at the historic governor's mansion in Des Moines.
We join you this morning from Boulder, Colorado, after spending the week on a cross-country road trip, speaking with voters across the nation. I hear people talk all the time about, I don't know why this person is a better candidate than the other person, and I think that's a role this week plays so well.
As the program took shape, so eventually did our Sunday morning family.
Well, we're three people, and each of us is quite different. Donaldson has made quite a reputation for himself by being an aggressive reporter, which he is, because some of his questions I wouldn't want to ask, but I don't mind hearing the answers.
I get to ask the question. You're right. You get to give whatever answer you want. Okay, my question is, do you want to ban abortion?
George Will is extremely bright and quite conservative. And you can always count on him for some kind of thoughtful point of view about whatever the topic is.
George, what are these annotations here?
Well, I mean, I could give dramatic readings from this
instructive
book.
Oh, my gosh. Cokie Roberts is irreplaceable. She brought such a wealth of knowledge.
Here on our new set, new program, but a lot of familiar faces. Saints
That's right.
Especially.
It looks new, but folks, it's kind of old in a way, too.
Particularly when Cokie was on the anchor desk. As a woman, she could ask different kinds of questions and bring that to the viewers.
Womanize is a broad term. What is your definition of the term?
I don't know.
Well,
I'll simply say to you that if you take
it, Cokie, do you have a definition of the term?
Well, I think most women know it when they see it, Senator.
The role of the anchor of this week is to encapsulate what has just happened, what has dominated the week, and what is going to be driving the following week.
It is a huge responsibility, and I think about it every day when I come in to not only prepare for the show, but to sit in that anchor chair and hopefully ask the questions that our viewers need to hear.
Having the chance to follow in the footsteps of David Brinkley is just such a privilege, and he set the standard. I actually had three first appearances on this week. The first one was in July 1992 during the Clinton campaign, where I was grilled by Sam Donaldson and George Will.
Does the Gore choice look as good now without Perot in the race? as it did to your strategists when you thought it might be a three-man race.
Core choice looks better than ever.
Then in 1997, I joined This Week as an analyst, and I was a kind of a friendly sparring partner with Bill Kristol.
Welcome, George.
Good to see you.
And Bill Kristol, I feel like, you know, you've been left out of all of this discussion of George joining this, and we're really glad you're here.
Thank you, Bill.
And in 2002, I took over the anchor chair, and I was very grateful to my daughter, Elliot. She came early so that I was able to anchor that week. Welcome to our program and our first guest, the President's National Security Advisor, Dr. Condoleezza Rice.
We'll be back shortly with our free-for-all discussion here in the studio.
The roundtable has played a central role in This Week.
Welcome to our roundtable.
Thanks, Sam.
We're glad to have you. Now, that may be the last kind word anyone says to you today.
It's more than I expect.
You're there to provide some analysis.
I have a simple question for each of you. Very, very simple. Why? How would you characterize President Clinton's start? Do we need all these polls?
I look at this poll, and George, I don't like to read polls in the morning without wine.
wine in the morning?
Come on, from Louisiana. Yeah.
The roundtable is almost always unpredictable, which is why I believe it is always must-see television.
I think I have lost control of this.
There are probably dozens of people in Dallas alone who don't read your magazine.
Wait. I don't like the way this conversation is going.
Back in the wrong direction.
The great achievement.
And but just one final thing, because I do have a great achievement.
And that may be true, but my point
is... You can't make the last point, because we're out of time.
You guys can all go. We're going to say here.
Now more than ever, we need shows like This Week, where people can know that they're going to come and get information, real information, about the decisions politicians and policymakers are making every single day that affect their lives. That tradition is going to continue.
For all of us at ABC News, until next week, thank you.
How great to see David Brinkley right there. What a privilege to be part of this program for the last 25 years. Hi, everyone. George Stephanopoulos here. Thanks for checking out the ABC News YouTube channel. If you'd like to get more videos, show highlights, and watch live event coverage, click on the right over here to subscribe to our channel. And don't forget to download the ABC News app for breaking news alerts. Thanks for watching.